manifested in us. Well, that's what the four steps all about, is to find out, let us see for ourselves just how these warped instincts have manifested in what we call defects of character. And therefore, the four step is designed specifically for us to locate, to find, to recognize and accept four cardinal defects: resentment, dishonesty, selfishness, and fear. Resentment, dishonesty, selfishness, and fear. That's what the fourth step is all about, to locate these defects. It also provides us with the vehicle by which we can see the harm that we've done others, and therefore to become cognizant of the fact that we've harmed them and become willing to make amends where we can. So we do a good most of our eighth step as we do our fourth step. Now then, in the fifth step, we're going to be admitting these defects. These are the same defects which we find in the 10th step and in the 11th step. Both of those inventories contain precisely the same four: resentment, dishonesty, selfishness, and fear. And so we know that the Big Book is always consistent about this. Please notice that the Big Book does not recognize sin, deadly or otherwise. Sin is not a part of the practice of the 12 steps. We find it in other literature, but we never find it in the Big Book. What we're not talking about making any judgments about the sinfulness or lack of sinfulness of our actions. What we're looking to see is what didn't work, what stopped working, if it ever did. We're looking to see what has caused our failures in life, what has caused us to be so vulnerable that we have become dependent upon alcohol or other substances in order to survive. What is it about ourselves which has so weakened our conscious contact with God that we no longer have His protection? Now, your sponsees may very well come up with other aspects of their personality or other things about themselves that they don't like, and that's fine. Whatever it is they want to throw in there, as long as they've got the four cardinal defects, anything else is fine too, because upon close examination we will find, let's take one example, jealousy. Jealousy is always the product of fear, isn't it? Always. It is also the product of selfishness and self-centeredness. So we're really looking at self-centered fear. And when we have identified selfishness and self-centered fear as one of our defects, we've really covered jealousy. Bad temper. Bad temper always means that we get angry easily. And anger is always a product of fear. Many times it also relates to our pride. Many times to our selfishness. But we're going to find that in every instance, these objectionable parts of our character, once we follow them through, all relate in one way or another to one or more of the cardinal defects. More importantly, to recognize that they will always, and each and every one, will relate to fear. Because fear is the progenitor, the trigger, the motive force behind every one of our defects. So therefore, we're going to carry into the fifth step the knowledge that we have obtained about our defects, our insanities. But we're going to do more than that. We're going to carry into the fifth step what we have learned about these defects, in the sense, for example, that we have no power over them. We can't get rid of them ourselves. We're going to carry into the fifth step the knowledge of just how ruinous and cancerous these defects have been. Now, they're just exactly like those termites that you can't see that are eating away the foundations of your house. And one day the floor collapses or the roof collapses. We know that they're there because we have bothered to find out. We have seen all of the results. So we know that the defects are there. We know we can't get rid of them. We've come to understand that these defects constitute a form of insanity. In other words, quite simply, our brains don't work right. We've come to believe that God can restore us to sanity. Now, it ought to be a simple step from there to being willing to let Him. And so a big part of the four step is to come to that exact conclusion. Now, remember that all of the steps work together. You cannot, we must not ever take one step and set it apart as being a separate entity. And many people who purport to be sponsors do exactly that. And some of the literature which we have does exactly that, attempts to set the steps off as if they existed on their own, independently of the other steps. That's not true of any of them. All of the steps depend upon the steps that came before and build toward the steps which are coming after. And so we have to look now at the fifth step in that light. The fifth step is dependent upon and building upon what we learned in the fourth step, but is building toward the sixth, seventh, eighth, and ninth steps. More than that, it becomes one of those permanent tools in our toolbox of spiritual tools which we're going to use the rest of our lives. And so it's an extremely important step for us to do as thoroughly and completely as possible. As a sponsor, you would counsel severely against any sponsee being unwilling or even delaying very much in taking this step. Remember, too, that we have learned by this time that there are seven spiritual tools in our toolbox. Each one of those tools is the product of our learning. Learning not only intellectually, but learning by doing how to use these steps. The first of these seven steps is inventory. That's the fourth step, isn't it? The second of these spiritual tools is found in the fifth step, admission. The third is found in the sixth and seventh steps, submission to God. So we find our defects, we admit them, and then we submit them to God for His help. The fourth of these tools is amends, setting matters straight, the ninth step. We learn to make amends. We learn that we can make amends. We learn that when we make amends, it actually works. And then we have prayer, which runs through all the steps, is especially mentioned, of course, in the 10th and 11th steps. We have meditation, which again runs through all the steps. We find it mentioned over and over again, seven different times. Meditation is the subject of the big book, especially in the 11th step. And the seventh of the tools is service to others, carrying the message. Carry this message to other alcoholics. You can help when no one else can. Probably, in the final analysis, the 10th, 11th, and 12th steps are a pattern of living. The big book says that the spiritual life is not a theory, that we have to live it. And once we have learned these tools, once we have completed our first nine steps, from there on, we're working and living in 10, 11, and 12.